Having your Facebook ads account banned is one of the most common problems people face when they are starting out with e-commerce or with dropshipping. Especially if you are just starting out with your ads, this is a problem that many people face. So, how we are going to address this problem, and most importantly, how we are going to avoid getting your Facebook ads account banned in the first place. Hi there, I am Rehab, and on this YouTube channel, I share with you videos related to e-commerce, entrepreneurship and more. And in today's video, I'm going to help you to avoid getting banned from Facebook. So let's start. In order to secure your Facebook ads account, there are many things that you can be doing. Some of these things are related to your website, others are related to your personal account, and others are related to Facebook Business Manager account. And we are going to talk about all these three segments. But before doing that, let me tell you something about Facebook. Facebook is an advertisement platform, and Facebook wants to make sure that its users are satisfied. That's why Facebook tries to ensure good quality when it comes to ads. That's why when people buy some products through Facebook ads, Facebook sends follow-up emails to those people and asks them about their experience with these purchases and with these stores. Usually, Facebook asks about the shipping and the product quality and things like that. Based on these answers, Facebook will give your page a score. If your score is below 2, it means you can't run ads. If your score is above 2, it means you are safe and you can run ads. If you got a low score, you can always get back to Facebook and prove to them that you are trying to improve your shipping conditions or your product quality and stuff like that. However, the best thing you can do is to avoid getting a low score. When you start advertising, you will not have a score yet because Facebook doesn't know anything about you. So with the first ad you start running, with the first purchases you start getting, Facebook will start getting queries about you and asking people about you, and Facebook will decide what score to give you to your page. So now, after understanding more about page score and why this is very important, there are many things that you can do to avoid getting low score. The best thing you can ever do is to give good shipping conditions and to sell good products with good quality. When it comes to shipping conditions, usually in e-commerce, shipping is good, but when it comes to dropshipping, especially if you are dropshipping from AliExpress or from China, shipping times might be a little bit big. That's why in this case, it's better to find closer suppliers to your customers, or you can find another solution, for example, by stating clearly to your customers that your shipping time is big, or by trying to find local suppliers in the countries where you are selling. So when it comes to product quality, if you are producing the product, so you know the quality, but if you are not producing the product and you are a dropshipper, you might not be able to actually judge the quality of the products you are selling. So the best thing you can do is to check out the reviews, to ask for a sample, to try out the product yourself to make sure that you are providing a good value. Now that you understand what is a page score and why it is important, I want to talk about something different, and I want to give you a very important advice. Running ads is something very important, and it's something that can insanely scale your business. But relying only on ads will make you always relying on Facebook or on a third-party platform to run your business. So if you want actually to have a sustainable business, a strong business, you should not be putting all your eggs in one basket, and you should be working on different kinds of marketing strategies. So in addition to running ads, you should be also collecting your customers' leads, you should also be working on your SEO, you should also be working on your social media platforms, and most importantly, you should be working on creating a personal relation with your customers in order to be able to retain them and make them your loyal customers. In order to be able to create such a business, you should be applying a specific work frame that will allow you to get customers and most importantly to retain them. To know more about how to create such a business and how to create a business that doesn't depend entirely on Facebook ads, a business that can be sustainable, a business that doesn't collapse because your ads account got banned or because ads cost got insanely high, I highly recommend you to check the free workshop I have prepared for you. In this workshop, I show you step by step how you can create a business that's sustainable, strong, and at the same time, solid. So if you want your business to be able to live for years and to be sustainable, I highly recommend you to go to the description below and to get this free workshop. It's 100% free, you don't have to pay anything. Now getting back to Facebook ads accounts and how we can avoid getting banned. The first things we should be doing are things related to our website. When it comes to your website or your store should look professional because Facebook will go to your store and will check your store and will check if your store is spammy or not. So your store should have a custom domain name. If you are selling worldwide, it's better to have a .com domain name, and your website should have all the pages that can help your customers. For example, you should have an About Us page, you should have a private policy page, terms and services page, you should have a shipping page, a return policy page, everything your customers might be asking about or they might be hesitating about should be clear to them through these pages. Facebook wants to make sure that your customers have the best experience ever on your platform, on your store. That's why you should be providing all these pages because they are fundamental pages for users' experience. Other than that, you have to make sure that the content you are putting on your store is unique and that you are not copying this content from other websites. So, if you are dropshipping, don't go to other stores, copy their descriptions and paste it on your store. Write your own description. This is very important for Facebook and for Google. So, try to be authentic and to have a professional store with good content, unique content, content that you have created yourself. Same for blog posts and everything else. Having a blog is optional, however, it's a plus when it comes to Facebook judging your website. So these are mainly the things that you should be doing on your website. Now moving to your Facebook personal account. When you start running ads, you will be running ads through your business manager, but at the same time, you will be using your own personal account to run ads. If you are using your personal account, if it's an old account with an organic engagement, if you have changed your profile pictures, interacted with people, if it's a normal Facebook ads account, if this is the case, this is very good because it means that Facebook will easily know that there is a real person behind this personal account, so you are most probably safe. However, if you want to use a brand new Facebook account, so if you want to create a personal account for your business only, in this case, things will be a little bit more tricky because you need to prove to Facebook first that your personal account is authentic before starting to run ads. Which means don't create a personal account and hurry up to start creating ads because most probably you will get banned. If you want to use a unique account for your business, create your personal account, run it for a few weeks, make it look natural, add photos, add friends, engage. Then move on to creating ads and business accounts and so on. But my personal recommendation for you is to use your own personal account. Because even if you give your new account some weeks to look real, Facebook will still see that it's a new account. However, if you are using an account that's been live for years with a true engagement, an organic engagement, it would be easier for Facebook to judge you and decide not to ban your account. In addition to that, something I highly recommend is to take the Facebook Ads Policy course. When you take this course, this will be mentioned on your profile, so Facebook will know that you took this course, and this will make you more trustworthy because it will show Facebook that you are serious about respecting the policies and about playing between lines. So mostly this is it for your personal account. Now let's talk about your Facebook page and your Instagram page. Having a Facebook page and Instagram page to run ads is mandatory. You can't run ads without having these pages. However, it's not enough to have these pages. You have to make them also look professional and authentic. So you have to start posting on these pages to have cover photos and to have profile pictures, and you have to include all the information within the Facebook page and the Instagram page. In this way, you will look like a true brand, a real brand that Facebook can trust. The next thing you should be doing, and it is related to your Facebook page, is to take care of your page score. We have talked before about page score and how important it is. You have always to follow up the score and to make sure that you are always trying to improve your services and your products. One very, very powerful idea would be to send follow-up emails to your customers. to follow up with people who have purchased from you. In this way, if you send several emails to people who purchased from you, like directly after purchase, maybe 2 days after purchase, it's like a flow, a post-purchase flow. You will make sure that if your customers have any problem, they will be getting back to you, not to Facebook. So in this way, you will be reaching out to them before Facebook reaches out to them. So until now, we have talked about the things that you should do on your website, your personal account, and your Facebook and Instagram pages. Now we are going to talk about the things that you should be doing inside your business manager account, and this is the most important part in this video. There are many things that we are going to do inside of your business manager, but the first thing you should be doing is to verify your business. If you have already registered your business, this is very good because it means you can easily verify your business. However, if your business is not registered yet, I recommend you to go and register this business. So in this way, you will make everything legal and you will be able to get credit cards and debit cards in the name of your business. To get verified, your business account should have the same name as your business. If this is not the case, it's a little bit difficult to get verified. It would be also very positive if your payments, like your credit cards or your debit cards, have the same business name as well, or at least your own name. In this way, you will be the owner and you can explain to Facebook why you are using these payments and these credit cards. The first thing to do is to go to People in here and to start adding personal accounts. It's very important to add more than one account because in this way you will secure that multiple people have an access to your business account. If you have two personal accounts, I recommend you to add both of them. However, if you don't, you can add the account of your partner or your mother or your sister. The most important thing is to add a personal account that looks authentic and real, a real personal account, not a new account that you have just created. So, add multiple people in here, give them access, make them admins or employees, it depends on you, but it's very important to add multiple people, and this way you will make sure that you are keeping things secure and safe. Now you head to page in here and you add your own page. Then you go in here to Instagram accounts and you add your own Instagram account. Then you go down in here to your payment methods. And I recommend you to add at least two different payment methods. Then after payment methods, you go to business info and here you have to fill all the information. It's very important to fill everything because in this way you will look like a verified business and a serious authentic business. So fill out all the information, verify your business from here and make sure to add two-factor authentication because this is something Facebook recommend. In here, Facebook will tell you how many ad accounts you can manage. It depends on your page age and how much information you have filled. So once you finish everything, check how many ad accounts Facebook will allow you to create. When you know how many accounts you can create and when you fill all the information in here, you go back to your ad accounts in here and you start creating your ad accounts. I recommend you to create multiple ad accounts. This is very important because in this case, if one ad account got banned, you still have another ad account to use. So create as much as possible ad accounts, as much as Facebook allows you to create. After finishing with that, I recommend you to go in here to brand safety and to go click on domains and to verify your domain. Actually, this became more important after the iOS 14 new update, and Facebook now asks websites to verify the domains, so go and do that. This is mostly everything you need to do in here. The most important thing is to fill all your information and to add multiple payment methods and to make sure that you have connected all the pages and created multiple ad accounts and added multiple people to manage the business account. For sure, make sure to add people that you trust. So in this video, I did my best to talk about everything you need to do in order to avoid getting banned. However, the number one thing that you should always keep in mind is to respect Facebook guidelines and Facebook policies. Before leaving, I want to invite you one more time to go to the description below and to get my free workshop. In this free workshop, I show you how to create a sustainable e-commerce business. I show you the ultimate work frame you should be adopting in order to make your business solid and strong and in order to make your business live for years. When you apply this work frame to your business, you will not worry because your Facebook ads account got banned, because you will be able to reach out to your clients through multiple channels other than Facebook ads. This work frame will help you to retain your customers and make them long life customers. So if this is something you are interested about, I highly recommend you to go to the description below and to click on the link and to get this free workshop. Thank you for watching, and if you liked this video and found it informational, please show me some love by liking it and by subscribing to my channel. See you soon. Bye bye.